Some passionate rhetoric about climate change in 2019 has caught the attention of the world. It caught my attention and jogged my memory of some observations I made as a teenager and one shocking discovery I made a few years ago. But first, I will let the two headline-making ladies say their bit in their own words.
The world is going to end in 12 years if we don't address climate change. And your biggest issue is... Your biggest issue is how are we going to pay for it?
People are suffering. People are dying. Entire ecosystems are collapsing. We are in the beginning of a mass extinction. And all you can talk about is money and fairy tales of eternal economic growth.
I have to say, these two must have access to more data than I do. But then again, most people do. For nearly my entire childhood and adolescent life, my father did contract work for the U.S. Forest Service. It was in 1991 that we took a contract in the Dixie National Forest on the high Markagunt Plateau just east of Cedar City, Utah, near Duck Creek Village. The particular task was to fall trees that had been killed in a forest fire with the intent of providing protection and moisture retention for young trees. It was here that we noticed that a compass did not always point north. Depending on where you were, the needle could point in the wrong direction. The contract called for the aligning of the fallen trees in a very specific orientation to maximize protection from the brutal northern winds. In order to achieve the correct alignment of the trees, we had to calibrate our compasses for magnetic delineation. This is because the magnetic North Pole is not at the North Pole. At that time, it was roughly plus 13.8 degrees. And herein, we discovered some abnormalities and inconsistencies. Most of the trees could be properly aligned using the compass, but some would end up pointing in the wrong direction. Why? So a little more detail about the Markagunt Plateau. Well, as Wikipedia so eloquently puts it, Markagunt Plateau is a volcanic field in southern Utah. This is where Mammoth Cave is located, one of Utah's largest caves. So the theory goes like this. The high iron content in the lava caused abnormalities in the magnetic field, producing faulty compass readings. Well, that was cool. As I thought about the magnetic delineation over the years, I stayed interested in the fact that the charts continuously had to be updated. Back in 1991, the delineation for Cedar City, Utah was roughly plus 13.8 degrees. Today, it is plus 11.14. When I first saw the plots of the different locations of the magnetic North Pole, I immediately saw something exciting. I found out that the magnetic North Pole is not just wandering around. It's been accelerating like a bandit speeding away from a robbery. I was excited to notice the acceleration, but when I saw the shape of the graph, my brain lit up. I had seen this graph shape before. It very closely resembled the shape of the global temperature graph. They even both contained the distinctive camel hump during the 1940s. So what causes the Earth's magnetic field? Well, the best we can tell, it is movement of magma in the outer core deep in the bowels of the Earth. So if we are detecting changes in the position of the magnetic poles, that should mean there are changes happening to what is causing it. Changes in the core of the Earth. Changes are most certainly happening because the strength of the dipole magnetic field is weakening. From 1900 to now, it has lost at least 2 units, as this graph by Wikipedia contributor Cavett shows. Actually, if the strength of the position of the magnetic field are dictated by motion of magma, is there any chance that volcanic activity could be changing on a global scale? Bam! Yes, there is. The same camel hump over the 1940s, and it's increasing. Mind blown. What is going on here? Why is this happening? CO2 levels in the atmosphere are also rising, but the CO2 emissions lack that camel hump during the 1940s. Very curious here. So this is the question. How are increasing global temperatures connected to the increase of volcanic activity, increase in the movement of the magnetic North Pole, and decrease in the strength of the dipole? I need answers and so do you, so let's work together to come up with a solution before it's too late.
Woke up